apologize if it's not exactly with your specialty, but I think it will be. So it's in regards to the sort of workforce development and building the the projects between businesses that are doing business with the city. And I guess my question was, are you guys involved in spreading awareness to even larger suppliers, large companies, particularly in the construction industry, large companies, in terms of their awareness of social procurement and how that relates to the supply chain of subcontracting and large suppliers and community development, just so that other suppliers are aware of that and that's something they're aware of?
Yes, so the program to social procurement has two components, supply chain diversity and workforce development. So workforce development is included in projects that are 5 million and above with minimum duration of 2 years. For this year, 17 projects are including workforce development. And we are working with consultants, like large consultant firms, and on their proposals, we include the opportunity for them to propose and how they can provide business opportunities to certify diverse suppliers and social enterprises.
So from the large construction firms, you're asking for their proposals, how they can? Also, oh, you're asking for them, oh, okay.
Yes, yeah, so on those projects, we have language that for proponents and contractors. So in RFPs, we ask for proponents to propose a plan and how they can include, even on the duration of the project that they have been awarded, how they can provide business opportunities for social enterprises and diverse suppliers. And for tenders, we are more specific. So we put target numbers for construction companies to include opportunities for social enterprises.
Does that answer the question?
Yeah, I guess I was wondering, is there a metric? Like, is there a metric? I just feel like maybe if it's open, I just feel like it's kind of open. And it's not necessarily married. Is there a metric that they have to hit as their target? I just feel like maybe it's kind of open, and I know, I'm sorry to kind of
No, it's okay. I can repeat the question. So the gentleman is asking like if there's a specific target, because it sounds like it may be a little bit vague.
So to give you an example, in tender, we are more specific. Just to, let's say, the duration of the project, sometimes it's 5 years, 10 years. We asked the contractor to provide one business opportunity per year for a diverse supplier or a social enterprise.
Exactly.
So
it could be a week,
example.
Or it could be a 2 month project, it could be a 2 day project, it could be a 1 day project. So that's what I mean. And maybe there's not an answer to that, but I guess that's what I'm proposing to the panel is that they're creating a metric for that. So whether it could be a 1 day opportunity, right? Which they could say, okay, I checked off that box, or I know there's large contractors who hired, done large job fairs and done big hiring projects and haven't hired any of the youth. I've organized those job fairs for them, and they haven't hired any of them. So I'm just saying, I think there needs to be more of a metric and more of accountability towards some of the larger suppliers to make sure that they're actually being accountable, which I'm sure you guys are doing, but I'm just putting that out there.
Are you talking about business opportunities or job opportunities?
The whole spectrum of workforce development, whether it's connecting to business opportunities, directly subcontracting, or the job fairs.
Job opportunities, provide on tenders specific numbers. What is the target that we want to achieve during the duration of the project? So let's say 3 apprentices or 5 job opportunities, and we list, we provide them a list of trades that we want these apprentices from. So tenders is more specific. In RFPs, we ask for the governments to provide a plan.
That's a good suggestion. Thank you for bringing it up. We have another question.